Marty, if you're watching, keep it going. But we're watching the video there from Wrecking Ball. I mean, let me ask you, as a dad, I'm a dad, just had a little baby girl. She's nearly 2 years old. So I'm going to go through all this when she's in her teens and stuff. And I don't know how comfortable I will feel if I see my girl suddenly turning into a twerker. What is it like for the dad in you, not the artist, but the dad, Billy Ray, to watch his girl on stage, not wearing many clothes, doing the twerking, and then the wrecking ball and so on?
Piers, let me warn you, it gets even stranger when that little girl becomes a young lady.
Right.
And then you go on Twitter and you see where people have put her on top of your head. And I've seen the craziest things, again, just looking at it. And I get a laugh out of it, too. Like, I've seen some crazy stuff. Twitter, I think, has just been, it's the universal language. I mean, you stay in touch again with the love and the hate, but that's people's emotions.
Does any of it make you feel uncomfortable, though, as a dad or not?
As a dad?
Yeah.
Not really, because I'm
almost curious. I was watching it myself. I think this is brilliant. But I was thinking, if I was Billy Ray, and I've got the pleasure of getting to know you pretty well, I just wonder what the dad in you feels, whether you can celebrate the glory of the pop moment, but also be a little bit like, blimey, my girl's grown up.
There she is. That's very accurate there. Then, you know, for me to think how hard she's worked to get to this point, and what a risk, just the fact that she went and cut her hair off. That was huge. She could have stayed Hannah Montana forever and made a great living doing that, but she's more of an artist than that, and she wanted to evolve, and she had to take her time, let that evolution take place. And again, she's very, very smart, and she's had all of this thought out in advance. There's been times where I've seen, you know, things going on with my life. She knows the chart. She set a path. She knew what she wanted to do. And in today's world, the shock factor is tremendously higher than it used to
be. But also with Miley, I always feel that it's not like we see her stumbling out of nightclubs or in some sort of scandal or, you know, the sort of sex, drugs, rock and roll stuff you might see with Lindsay Lohan and the others. I've not seen that side to her. I mean, have I missed it all, or is she actually pretty good?
She's never been arrested. You know, she's really very focused and loves what she's doing. That's the main thing for me as a dad, to see my little girl doing what she loves, making the music that she loves to make, and hanging out with some incredibly talented producers, singer-songwriters, the musicians, the people that's around her right now. It's just a great abundancy of creativity.
And she's lucky to have you, because you've been through all this after Achy Breaky Heart. You exploded around the world. I remember that well. And also, you know, her mum, Tissue, I've just been having a chat with her about. I never really talked to her before. Delightful lady, very strong, and very close to Miley, obviously, as well. But let me put this to you. So you're a part of the Parent Television Council, known for conservative values. They attacked the performance, and they attacked MTV. They said, once again, succeeded in marketing sexually charged messages to young children using former child stars and so on. You've seen all that. You're a responsible guy, and I know you're a respectful man in that sense. What is your response to those like that council and like people that have subscribed to it who have got serious concerns about what Miley did?
Well, I'm on the council, you know. I will say, in 10 years, I don't recall ever being invited to a meeting, so I'm not exactly sure what the council does. But I started.
Well, they get very angry about things like that.
They sure do too. My first series was called Doc, and that's kind of when it started on PAX Television. Then we came and did Hannah Montana, and again, I've been on that council for a while. But you know, hey, everybody's entitled to their opinions. You know, that's, you know, the old saying. You know the old saying, right? I mean, you don't want me to say it, do you?
You can.
Well, opinions. Opinions are like, everybody has one. You know what I'm talking about.
On a personal level.
Fill in the word.
Did you get angry about when people go after Miley, given she is only 20 and they attack her? You've seen the Twitter stuff sometimes.
Oh,
a lot of it's very positive, but a lot of it's vicious.
Oh, Lord. I'm her daddy, you know. I think at times, you know, being her dad, I may take it a little more serious. That's my daughter, you know. I have had to learn, you know, just stay focused on what you love. Do what you do because you love it. Be thankful and grateful for the fans that you have that do appreciate the art that you make. And you know what? Again, you know, for every action, there is an opposite and equal reaction.
Do you think she'd be the biggest pop star in the world, though? I mean, she's been famous, but this is like a whole new level, isn't it?
It does seem like a whole new level. And yeah, she has been very famous, but she has risen to a whole new level. And it's, I thought I'd seen it all until these last couple of weeks. And it, the whole thing just kind of went to a whole new level.
Well, I think she's terrific, Miley
Thank
Cyrus.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I think she is too.
Brilliant bit of pop marketing. I think she's got great parents and she's got a great plan and she's having fabulous success. So long may she continue.